Jeff, one of the most decorated wrestlers in the history of the entire business, having become a certified legend both in a tag team with his brother Matt, as well as on his own. Both in the WWE and out of it, Jeff Hardy has asserted his legacy and established himself as one of the true greats. However, despite having held three world championships in the WWE, most people can agree that his sole run with the WWE Championship in early 2009 left a lot to be desired. Despite being the most popular superstar not named John Cena and shilling out merchandise like his life depended on it, his WWE title reign was short and sadly forgettable. After having legitimized himself in 2008 after a series of memorable pay-per-view scraps against the likes of Randy Orton, Edge, and Triple H, Jeff finally won the big one, defeating the latter two in a fantastic triple threat at Armageddon to capture his one and only WWE title. You'd think, therefore, since he was so popular and WrestleMania was right around the corner, that WWE would have some major plans for Jeff, right? Right? Well, kinda, if their plan was to waste him. Jeff, after going through a series of accidents both on and off camera, implying a mystery attacker, Jeff would lose the WWE title right back to Edge in a hard-hitting match at the Royal Rumble after his brother Matt would turn heel and reveal himself to be the attacker. Unfortunately, things would fail to improve from here as Jeff would unsuccessfully try to regain the belt at No Way Out and would then shockingly fall to his brother in a disappointing street fight at WrestleMania 25. He would then lose to Matt again in a stretcher match on the next SmackDown before getting his win back at Backlash. Jeff would then go on to defeat Edge at Extreme Rules to win his first World Heavyweight title, leading into his excellent feud against CM Punk before leaving the WWE in the fall and not returning again until 2017. While his pair of world title reigns later in the year were booked well, his sole reign with the WWE Championship most certainly could have been better. Despite beginning the road to WrestleMania as champion, Jeff was nowhere near the title picture by the actual show of shows, and even ate a loss at the grandest stage of them all. It's a miracle that Jeff didn't lose all his credibility after that. So today, we're going to go back to 2009 and rebook Jeff Hardy's WWE Championship reign. So starting off, and this is going to sound really stupid, but please listen, Jeff will still lose his title to Edge at the Royal Rumble. Now I know, this sounds really stupid considering what I was just saying about his run being too short and forgettable, but hear me out. So yes, Jeff loses at the Royal Rumble, but not because of Matt Hardy, because of Christian. Yes, Christian returns earlier than in real life from TNA to help his good buddy Edge regain the WWE title. This was actually the original plan, apparently, but all the fans predicted it when they heard Christian had re-signed, so WWE thought it was too obvious and they went with somebody less predictable. That really ended up paying off in the long run, though, didn't it, WWE? So yes, Christian returns earlier than he did in real life, and the pair even posed for the benefit of those with flash photography over Jeff's prone body in the middle of the ring, instantly giving Christian some major heat and credibility upon his return. You know, instead of Todd Grisham going, "Oh, it's Christian." So on the next SmackDown, Edge is having a celebration, and he's having it with Christian, his quote-unquote wife Vicky Guerrero, Chavo Guerrero, Bam Neely, and all of those guys, when the Hardy Boys reunite and look like they're going to attack them. Christian and Edge each grab steel chairs, and the crowd is going wild at the prospect of the Attitude Era being revived right here, right now. But hold on a second, what's this? Christian instead cracks his chair over Edge's back. Christian fights off Neely and Chavo with more cracking chair shots before hitting Edge with a concerto. The Hardys are at ringside looking very confused, and so are all the fans. The following week, Christian explains that at the Royal Rumble, he only returned and helped Edge regain the title because he wanted to be the one to beat Edge for the championship and finally get out of his shadow. So now it's been decided what the Elimination Chamber match is going to be at No Way Out. It's going to be Jeff Hardy versus Matt Hardy versus Edge versus Christian versus Triple H versus The Undertaker, which, yes, I believe has the possibility to be the greatest chamber match of all time. So just for the record, the stuff going on with Randy Orton on Raw, I'm not touching that. He still attacks the McMahons and he still wins the Royal Rumble because that was actually a really good storyline. So Triple H, just like in real life, vows to win the Elimination Chamber so that he can face Orton at WrestleMania. So the chamber starts off with Jeff Hardy and Triple H. They go at it for a few minutes when Jeff, out of nowhere, shockingly rolls up Triple H for the very first elimination. So yeah, Triple H is taking Edge's place with a quick elimination in this version of events. And oh boy is he pissed. He beats Jeff within an inch of his life, banging him against the pods and pedigreeing him on the steel grate. Triple H officially turns heel, and security has to drag him out by force. He'll return later in the night to steal Kofi Kingston's spot and win the World Heavyweight Championship. Since the fans were already cheering for Randy Orton on Raw and booing Triple H, I feel like it's important to do a double turn here and make Triple H a proper heel. And quite frankly, Triple H was always best as a bad guy anyway. So medical staff tries to move Jeff out of the chamber, but then the buzzer goes off and out comes Edge. Whoever the opportunist shoves the personnel away and tries to eliminate Jeff. But to the delight of the crowd, Jeff kicks out. Edge can't believe it, and neither can anyone else. So then Edge calls in La Familia to invade the chamber and they start whooping on Jeff to the dismay of the fans. But before Edge can get a spear in, Matt's buzzer goes off and he fights off La Familia, saving Jeff in the process. They double team on Edge for a while until out of nowhere, Matt tries to eliminate his own brother. Jeff kicks out luckily and he seems hurt by this, but then he shrugs and he understands that the title is on the line. And so they shake hands, and they fight fairly for a while until BAM! Boom! Christian comes out, and he hits Edge's own spear on Matt and eliminates him from the chamber. Then Christian pulls a prone Edge back in the ring, and he hits him with an unprettier to pin and eliminate him just like he said he would. So then Christian drags Jeff up for another unprettier, but then he decides he's going to do it outside on the steel grating just to prove a point. But then Jeff wakes up, and he hits a twist of fate, pinning and eliminating Christian, much to the delight of the fans. But then, gong, The Undertaker comes out now, and he almost seems sorry for poor Jeff Hardy. But Jeff regains consciousness as he's being set for the tombstone. These two go back and forth for about 10 solid minutes. These two always had great chemistry in the ring, and it's on display once again here. In the end, Jeff hits a swanton off the pod and pins The Undertaker to heroically regain the WWE Championship, and the crowd comes absolutely unglued. With all that happened at No Way Out, you must be wondering, Rinzler, how could they possibly top that at WrestleMania? And to answer that, I have three letters for you. TLC. Yes, 8 years after their iconic WrestleMania 17 TLC match, it's going to be Jeff Hardy versus Matt Hardy versus Edge versus Christian in a TLC match for the WWE Championship. At an event titled the 25th anniversary of WrestleMania, what better way to showcase your history than putting four of your best performers in the prime of their careers in the match type that they made famous with the most prestigious title in the business on the line? So at WrestleMania, these four kill each other with death-defying stun after death-defying stun. This match is so good that it actually rivals Undertaker versus Shawn at the same show. In the end, Jeff retains the WWE Championship, winning at WrestleMania for the very first time in his career. After this, Jeff feuds with both Edge and Christian, defeating them in a triple threat at Backlash, and then just Christian on his own at Judgment Day, before defeating Edge in a ladder match at Extreme Rules just like he did in real life. Then CM Punk comes out to cash in his Money in the Bank briefcase, and the timeline is restored. The feud remains exactly the same, except in this timeline it's for the WWE Championship instead of the World Heavyweight Championship. So in short, Jeff is screwed over at the Royal Rumble, but it helps to legitimize a more believable top heel with Christian. Christian gets to get out of Edge's shadow, we get a phenomenal Elimination Chamber match out of it with Jeff getting one of the best performances of his career. Then we get another epic TLC match at WrestleMania. Even in defeat, Matt, Edge, and Christian will obviously seem very credible. Jeff gets his moment, and he gets two championship reigns instead of just one. I really think that nobody loses with this scenario, and that is how I would have booked Jeff Hardy's WWE Championship reign.